You know what I'm here for.
Back on top, punching the clock, clutching sanity. I got more cribs than Habitat for Humanity.
What's good, y'all? What a night of NBA basketball. We had the two best teams in the league going at it. The Lakers are without LeBron James, and they had a big game against the Sacramento Kings. And James Harden might be back. He might be. I'm here to talk about it, man. Be sure to leave a like, subscribe if you are new, and let's get into it. I typically wait till the next day to record the recap videos, but tonight was such a great night of basketball. It just has me excited and ready to record right away. The Phoenix Suns getting a win to extend their win streak to 17 games. Best team in the league right now, 18-3 record. Beat the Golden State Warriors. I believe it ended up being like a 10-point margin, but it was a very closely contested, great game. D-Book went down early with a hamstring injury, and I thought that might hinder the Suns because I thought they might say, okay, D-Book's out. Let's not try and put, you know, so much pressure to win this game. It's just a regular season game. We are 20 games in. No reason to put all of our chips on the table in a regular season game. But this is the two best teams in the league right now. So I'm glad that this lived up to kind of the expectation that we were setting on this game being one of the games of the year so far. And it definitely was that. First off, Chris Paul. Y'all know how I feel about Chris Paul. CP is that guy. He put on a masterclass performance tonight. It was complete, you know, art. How the way he played the point guard game. Not sure exactly what his final numbers look like. I don't even want to talk about them. But down the stretch, I believe CP played the entire fourth quarter, which was kind of a surprise. Played the entire fourth quarter, and especially in like the last like 8 minutes of the game, everything on the offensive side of the ball was predicated through him. He was making plays. He was, you know, surveying the floor, making the extra pass. He was playing complete point guard basketball, which is what Chris Paul is. He's the point guard for a reason. And he put on the masterclass performance. Like, the final numbers for him are not amazing. I just had to check him out real quick. 15 points, 11 assists. That's pretty much usual stuff for him this season. But the way he controlled the game down the stretch without having a Devin Booker was key. He hit timely shots to stop the bleeding, extend the lead to, you know, 3 points, extend the lead to 5 points. Made some big-time plays. He said in his post-game interview that he gave praise to DeAndre Ayton. He said, he is what makes us go. He is, you know, pretty much the engine for this team. If DA plays good, the Suns play good. And they got him involved early on. There were still some times in the game where I just love to see him be a little more aggressive. Or he just missed, like, easy shots that he should, you know, go up and dunk on people. Especially when the tallest player on the Warriors is 6'6", and Draymond Green. You should just, you know, go up strong and try and finish through the contact. And he would kind of go up, try and lay it up soft and miss a couple of them. But DA had a very good game. He put his print in the game early on, had 20-10. Actually 24-11 rebounds, very good game, very productive for him. Just creating second shots was key, especially in that first half. Campaign came off the bench, played really well. We got to give praise to Mikal Bridges because I don't know who voted for the defensive teams last season. Whoever voted for the defensive team last season, I don't know how Mikal Bridges didn't make it last year. But this year, he's legit, like, you could throw him in Defensive Player of the Year conversations. I think so. He guarded Steph Curry tonight pretty much from mid-first quarter on, and he had Steph Curry in jail. I believe Steph was like 4 for 21 on the game. This is the MVP frontrunner. Steph Curry having a great season, leading the league in scoring, just coming off, you know, big games over the past couple weeks. 4 for 21 shooting on the night for Steph Curry. That's not normal, and Mikal Bridges was in his pockets all game long. Which is a big reason why the Suns were able to win this game. Mikal Bridges' defense on Stephen Curry. I don't think he gets enough love. There's a reason why they gave him a nice contract before the season started. Because he impacts the game so much on the defensive side of the floor. It's incredible. He really put everything on the defensive side. Because he was 1 for 4 from the floor. Only had 2 points. Everything was on the defensive side of the floor. Shout out Jay Crowder. He hit some big time 3-pointers in that fourth quarter. Cam Johnson was great. Really just a great all-around game from the Suns. Especially considering Devin Booker pretty much missed the majority of this game. Hopefully the hamstring injury is not too serious. Now for the Warriors, I'm not going to put too much on this game. I think it's a good sign that Steph Curry did not play well, and this was still a closely contested game. It pretty much went down to the wire. You know, final couple minutes, the game was still in the balance. Jordan Poole was incredible. He had a big time first quarter. Otto Porter turned back the clock a little bit. He looked very good in this game, but Bielitsa gave them some good minutes off the bench. It's just like Steph struggled so much, and Steph was half the man we know he is. The Warriors mess around and win this game, honestly. So, not taking too much from it. Just a nice early season contest between two of the best teams in the league that lived up to the hype. And if you missed it, I feel bad for you. Another game that was going on at the same time, I was kind of peeking back and forth, but mainly focusing on the Suns-Warriors. The Lakers playing against the Sacramento Kings. We just got news earlier today. I'm recording this at midnight, so it's December 1st, about November 30th. LeBron is going to be out. He's in health and safety protocols, you know, coronavirus and stuff. We don't know how long he's going to be out, but he's got to go through all that stuff. So the Lakers are going to be without LeBron for another stretch of games. And I seen a stat that said, in LeBron's 4 years with the Lakers, he's missed as many games as he had his previous however many years in the league. Which is like, what, this is year 19. So 15 years in the league, he missed like 71 games. In his last four with the Lakers, he's missed 71 games. And I don't know if that even included tonight. He's missed a lot of time with LA, but this is why you have AD and this is why you have Russell Westbrook. So you can beat teams that you should beat when LeBron can't play. And first half, it didn't look good, but some big shots at the end of the half from Malik Monk really helped out. Helped cut the lead a little bit, gave the Lakers a little bit of momentum, and they're able to capitalize on that in the second half. Westbrook played really well. He's been playing a good stretch of basketball lately. Got to give a lot of credit to him. AD was actually a little more aggressive tonight. It wasn't just shooting mid-range jump shots. I like to see that from Anthony Davis. But it was really Malik Monk was a big difference in this game too. Wayne Ellington also played well. Bad loss for the Kings, man. They had this game pretty much double figures until mid-third quarter, and they blew it. And they ended up losing by about 20. So this is a very bad loss for the Kings, who looked like they might have been able to start turning it around a little bit, but now they're back pretty much where they were when Luke Walton was fired. And I know I sound super congested. I really apologize, but this is the last game I'm going to talk about in depth because I actually watched it. I did not watch Grizzlies and Raptors. The Grizzlies got the win without John Morant. They are 2-0 since John Morant has been out, not including the game that he got injured. And the Trailblazers beat up on the Pistons, which you kind of expect. And I didn't watch a second of those games, but I did watch the Nets and the Knicks. James Harden looked like James Harden for the majority of this game. The burst seemed there a little bit. Like, he was getting to the basket a lot more than he had been so far this season. I like James Harden when he is a playmaker, but given the circumstances of this team right now, the Brooklyn Nets, you don't have Kyrie Irving. KD's been asked to do a lot on the offensive side of the floor. James needs to start ramping it up a little bit in the scoring department. And tonight was a good step towards that. He looked very good. Bursting there, he was hitting shots, gets to the free throw line. Played his game. KD closed it out. I think he scored 11 of the last 15. He was big time. Game kind of could have went either way. A bad foul by Mitchell Robinson at the end allowed James Johnson to go to the free throw line and make two free throws. Before that, Evan Fournier had made a three to tie the game. It was a wild finish. I will say the Knicks fans really packed out the Barclays Center. It felt like a Knicks home game almost, but Knicks were able to get the win. For the Knicks, I like seeing Alec Burks find himself. This is my biggest takeaway from this game, other than James Harden. Alec Burks was somebody that was like a first round pick like 10 years ago or something like that. I want to say he might have been lottery. Yeah, he was the 12th pick in 2011, so 10 years ago, this man was a lottery pick. Didn't really work out in Utah, was injured and stuff. And he's really found himself with the Knicks. And I love to see it, man. I guess an older player. He's a 10-year, but he's a veteran player, really redefining his game, and now he's playing point guard, starting point guard for the Knicks since they took Kemba Walker completely out of the rotation. He's the lead ball handler, and he's been playing really well the last, you know, couple weeks of the season. I love seeing guys being able to find themselves even a little later in their career. We're kind of seeing Julius Randle redefine himself last season. We've seen a lot of guys redefine their games, but Alec Burks is finding, he's tapping into, you know, what maybe he was drafted to be. And it's a good sight to see. But yeah, good night to basketball. The Suns extend their win streak to 17 games. It's good to see both of the national TV games be very compelling. I think that's good because a lot of times you get, you know, one game might be good. The other one's a blowout because the team doesn't come to play or it's just a bad matchup. Both of the games were very good. And it was good to see. If you did enjoy, be sure to leave a like and subscribe once again. Daily uploads, it's December now. So I'm going to try my very best to upload every single day of this month. We got to hit 500 subs, man. We got to. So daily uploads until then. I appreciate y'all once again, and I'm out. Peace.
Off season. Let's work. Hey, plotting my escape this game.